So basically, we are here from last 2 to 3 weeks, actually. So, and the beautiful ecosystem that is current, basically, we are breathing a fresh air every day morning. That is the first and foremost thing that I would like to share, which is like breathing very relaxedly. Whereas when in our homes, like even to go out every day morning, I need to be worrying what, where, how, what and all items need to be brought. If I go there, how do I protect myself? All those the problems and the worries, I'm just keeping it outside and I'm leaving it without any problems and breathing a fresh air in the morning with relaxed one. So that's the first and foremost thing that we would like to share. And apart from that, there are a lot of very nice medical care. That the care that is being taken every day, we get a calls so that whether our temperature is good and how are we feeling, whether did we have Ayurvedic tea, herbal tea, kashayam, and all those things. So the care that we are getting for every day from the medical team is absolutely amazing. And that is something that we are really enjoying. And of course, we are also started with our spiritual routine. So every day we are doing yoga and every day we are doing puja. And of course, whatever the Adi Kailash ambience, we are really enjoying that very much. And yeah, so those are the main things which I would like to share.
So just continuing what I said, like I just wanted to take up one of the component. Of course, there are many, many components to talk about. Last, she said, last couple of weeks we are here, rather more than a week, more than a couple of weeks. The one thing, as he exactly said, the value of the fresh airs, what COVID has taught is we were, taking many things for granted. You know, that is one of the things, is a fresh air. Okay, so the social distancing and double cover, triple cover, whatever, whatnot, all the covers we are talking about. So when we are outside, I'm basically from Mumbai. So, everything's going out, always you carry certain kind of fears. Last 15, 16 days only, thanks God, thanks Swamiji, I have not smelled the sanitizer, So it was really surprising to me. I just realized that just day or back. Otherwise, sanitizer becomes a part of every actions. Going out. Touching people. Drive in a car. Wherever it is, this sanitizer become part of your fragrance. So the first thing is fresh air. The second is remove off all this chemical stuff. We are just getting something like that organic thing. Okay, so in that one is basically yeah so one is basically about a herbal tea. When we say, when I'm just talking about herbal tea, like of course I used to have a herbal tea outside, but here we are just seeing how this herbal tea is being made. Here the I've said our person who is preparing is going there and blacking it beautifully, organizing it, and morning itself the fragrance of it, and it's so beautiful. And he just explained this medical value of each and every leaves and other things. It was very good. And I this is remember it's remind me what Swamiji says always. Nature is there always to help us. Each one thing which is around us is there to help us, and it has the medical values. Unfortunately, over the period of time, it just become a one more leaf for us, and we left it. Okay, so it's nothing, anything not wasted over here. Every leaf has something to contribute to human society. So the nature touch and the way the humanity or human has been connected with the nature, I could be able to really see that. So that is one of takeaway I feel, and it's micro.
Just adding to the herbal tea. So the early morning, almost like 20, 10 to 20 different leaves that we will when we see the doctor when he prepares, so he goes and freshly plucks the leaves like a neem and then the lime leaves. So all the different types, maybe around 10 to 20 leaves, and the way in which he prepares, and especially right after the puja, and we used to have this herbal tea, and that gives us a very nice like aroma, and also the Ayurvedic care that we get, right? So every day morning, due to some climate change, if they are feeling like little walk, so all those problems, little irritation will go away. And we are really feeling like very much fresh, alive in the morning. And that is the one of the greatest thing which everybody outside the world should get. Because the more relaxed that you feel, even if in my house, so what will happen is my kid is actually, I'm also along with my family, means my kid and my wife. And in my home, there is only like two rooms or three rooms, like probably she just goes and comes back. But here it is like a complete, a very big campus, and I am just not being much worried about my family. And that is the feeling of that relaxation is what everybody should experience. And especially, of course, Swamiji has already given the work from home option. Like here, the internet is available. So there is no issues in the project or in any deliverable, especially if you are working from home or any IT professional like me, for example. I don't see any reason to not to come to Adi Kailash at this stage, because that is the main thing here. And the second aspect is, usually in offices, what happens, we have a stressful meetings and then we go outside. During the lockdown from past 2 years, the meetings and the deliverables were so stressful. So now in Adi Kailash, just after the meeting, if I just go outside, it's like complete refresh and come back. So that is something that a very good, we should really thank Swamiji for providing us such a beautiful ambience.
So aptly said, Agniya, you know, just after a stressful meeting, we just go out, breathe the fresh air, and, you know, just being in that ecosystem where every leaf, every, you know, stone sings the glory of Swamiji and has been blessed by Swamiji's presence. So the whole Adi Kailash is pregnant with the presence of Swamiji. And recently, actually a few months back, when Adi Kailash was only to be for the training of the Sannyas Training Center, and at that point, Swamiji had announced in the satsang that the Adi Kailash would not be open for anybody, for the public, but only for Sannyas Training Center. And we had many devotees, especially from Bangalore, feeling, oh God, you know, missing the banyan tree and being able to not be in the energy field of Adi Kailash. Now, you know, the Sublime Pontiff has opened up, so now all of us cannot just only visit, but just stay there and protect ourselves in the most safest place in India today, and in the cosmos, which is Adi Kailash. So beautiful that you're sharing.
Yes,
Ayavi Muktaya, go ahead.
Yes, so that's the exact point I wanted to take it up on. We are trying to talk to even our devotees, and most of them have already listened what Devi said. Okay, so this is a well-known. When Swamiji says it's going to be a fact, okay, it's going to, in around the September time, when the third wave is going to start, obviously humanity would not be in a position to take up that. Every day, even now, media claims that, you know, things are under control, okay. Just I want to share one of the real incident happened today. I happened to talk to one of our devotee, IA grad. When I just talked to him, he's in his home, Belgaum. So I just felt it's something wrong. I mean, normally he's a person who only lives in Mumbai. So when I just talked to him a little old, then he opened up. He lost his father just a week back. He's an 87-year-old person. He said, my father is so, you know, very health-wise, everything is a perfect man. And he lost then. He was just explaining that the city like Belgaum, it's not a, you know, metro city or something. He said, the media claims two deaths is happening every day. But he said there are four crematorium approximately. And every crematorium has a capacity of, you know, burning around 15 to 20 bodies. And it's all on queue. And if you are not going on next day, your ashes, even you will not get an ashes. So as per his calculation, he says simply, very simply 500 to 1,000. It can be there for one day. I got shocked. I know media is lying. I thought it's two, maybe 10. That's what, you know, my logic says, fine, five times six. But he says, come say come, that minimum it's going to be 500. I can't just digest. It is one city statistics.
Oh, God.
And now, one city statistics, and media claims it's under control. So imagine the situation when media comes to say, are the real situation happening? What's going to happen? When Swamiji just talked about the visualization of body getting thrown in, you know, Ganga and dog eating, it got trolled. Even for many of our devotees, we could not able to digest, or we don't wanted to accept the truth. okay, we have many reasons to stay, you know, we can't come, we have this reason, that reason, so many other reasons, you know, oh, it's opened up. So people say it's opened up in Tamil Nadu. So what? When it's opened up now, that's the way the third wave getting started. Okay, that's a signature for it. And we have seen this repetitive template many times from first wave to second wave. And it's well-controlled media. Of course, government have their own problems. You know, we can't blame them. But that's a reality. The ground reality is it is too big a number to accept. It's not even direct COVID. There are indirect COVID deaths are happening. So it's very important. And very clearly, third wave indicates for the kids. So I request all the devotees who has the kids in the, you know, I mean, I heard, you know, the double muted things means, you know, when it is double muted, I heard that, you know, even you will not have a difference of our cell and COVID cell. So that kids, the way in which the kids get affected will be in a exponentially faster way. That's what the records and scientific papers are saying. That's what UK is also going through. So, but if that's happened in India, where the infrastructure is already in the, you know, collapsed condition, it's very tough for us to imagine and talk about. So it's very important for all our devotees, just take a jump. When it is opened up, this is a time you don't need to worry about e-pass, these and that. Of course, this all now it's become a little simpler. So use this opportunity, come fast. And many times we made even our medical test and all in a very logistically, it's beautifully arranged. So like, you know, they don't need to sit and take a lot of things, you know, locally also our medical team have done so many arrangements. So it's a decision they have to take. Okay. It's very easy for, I'm absolutely, it is not no more. I mean, it's not a very difficult task wherever you are in India. It's not going to be very difficult to reach it to Bangalore and Adi Kailasa. So it's not at all difficult. There's no point in giving excuse more and more and more. We have to understand the reality of it. Start moving it. Okay.
Adding to this point, so especially right now, when we want to join Adi Kailash, or especially when I spoke to many people, so we are just, what we are doing is like my friends, I'm just talking like few of the devotees and few of them. So all of them, it seems to be like waiting for something to happen in a larger extent, right? So because right now the situation is we can easily reach Adi Kailash, so that infrastructure, that facility is there. So my sincere request is to not to wait till the last moment or till any of your near and dear ones is getting affected, and that is going to put us into more trouble reaching here. And that time when we reach here, like what is the practical, like how to transport all the luggages and all the, and how to get the e-pass and the nationwide lockdown. So one of the, even if you see in my colleagues, the deaths that we are talking about, at least in my team, means when I'm working in IBM as one of the performance test engineer, and at least in my team at the nearest department, I can sense at least some 4 to 5 main, few of my own colleagues have actually dead. So they are no more basically. So what is happening is as the rate in which the death is happening and the rate in which we are listening to that, and we should not wait for our near and dear ones to get affected and then start running towards Adi Kailash. So as Swamiji has already warned us with a clear vision, and Devi Parashakti has been, I mean, every day almost he is warning, she is warning every day about the third wave. I think this is the right time that we need to take a step and move towards Adi Kailash instead of waiting for any of the incident to start or any of the spark to start about the third wave. Even the spark itself will not be able to justify our, let's say if you are in North India or any other part of the world. So even you will have a fear to even come to the Adi Kailash till now, and then get inside the Adi Kailash. So now the doors are open. I think as soon as possible, we should run and make use of this beautiful opportunity that Swamiji has given and safeguard ourselves. As Swamiji has clearly mentioned, this year the only profit is being alive. So I think we should not have any other priorities except our own life, of course. Mm-hmm. And yeah, so that's one of the major thing which I would like to share for all of us who are actually still thinking to come towards Adi Kailash.
So here the message is very clear. Work from home beautifully works. Okay, there are many people here with the excellent Wi-Fi. They are doing their work. So there is no, no problem. Okay, they do attend meeting. I'm running business. So everything going very smoothly. So So who has already, doing work from home or who can manage today, even most of the companies, organizations are ready to have this kind of, just even talk to your management or other things, they are ready for this kind of setup. So please try to make your work from home, shift based to Adhikaras, it can work. Second is, as he exactly put it, for the kids, 99.9% of schools only run online. That's a very clarity of it. That's a very, very simple. And this is going to be the truth for this coming year also. Okay, so Prime Minister has spoken to many of the state government and most of the exams are getting postponed. Even if it happened, it's going to be online. There is no way the physical schooling is happening. Third, let us understand Swamiji has given completely an open environment. Tomorrow, if anything is there, you can always go back. And you know, after the test, you can come back also. There is nothing called a time restrictions one. So that from all the logical point of view also, just take one decision and jump into this board. Okay, so that's
I would also like to add one more point, the work from home, right? So actually, it's not going smoothly. I think it's going very efficiently, because what happens is in home, whatever the way you do, maximum you will come out of a room and again you will end up in the same environment. Usually what happens, you will have a TV, of course, and then you will see many people always get diverted. And if, for example, if your spouse is not actually following Swamiji's teachings completely, or sometimes you will just distract, right? But here what happens is, Swamiji's enlightenment ecosystem is completely available. Like as just Nanatma was also conveying, that in this entire ambience is pregnant with Swamiji's teachings. And the way the healing happens, it's not only the work from home, even for your family members. My wife is actually pregnant. And now from past 15 days, she is such a relaxedly undergoing, no tension, no bother about the kids. So recently, 2 days before, we have taken their blood report as a regular checkup. And all the parameters are completely normal, like including the blood sugar levels and all other medical parameters are completely normal. And the more we live stress-free here, the more we are enjoying it. It's there are two extremes actually. Yeah. So one is, from the other side, in what happens is the more fear, more like stress, when you come to Adhikailas, it's like other way around. More relaxed and more efficient. On top of all those things, Swamiji's energy, Swamiji's the entire thing is vibrating with Swamiji's energy. So that is where there is a bigger shift, I think, that you will experience when you really come to Adhikailas and start living this quarantine.
So then specifically that immunity also. I mean, when you're with stress-free, your immunity levels goes up. And we have been given a proper, kashayam and all the proper Ayurvedic medication has been given. And Swamiji micromanagement is so good. Each and every one has been managed. They've been just followed up. Have you taken? Everything is fine and all that stuff. So the point I was just saying is, in outer world, it's more drive out of fear. Okay, when I say I'm not using sanitizer, the point is it's not that I'm not using sanitizer. Yeah, that there the fear, anything. Here also, we are perfectly, following all the stuff and in a very organic way. Okay, but the point is, there, it's just like, it has to be a part of you are overused. Yeah. Okay, you always overuse or, even everything or underuse, whatever it is. So this is a two things dilemma. Here it's that kind of a things are not there. It's very relaxed. Yeah. And immunity level, not because of not being stressful, immunity level is increasing. And that is from the work from home point of view. So even my mother is elderly one. He's come perfectly, comfortably settled down. And she's very happy in seeing the more people. Okay, it's really the community living is emerging based on the spirituality. Like, they come and the completion sessions are happening with some of the acharyas. That's very casually happening. And we have a Bhagavad Gita sessions happening in the evening time. Then we watch Swamiji Satsang, then Vakyartha is happening on that. So it's you can just say it's 100 years back, a village spiritual life. Typically, that's what Swamiji always love to say. Like, you just be there in a small village, a community, and the whole thing is working based on the temple. Temple ecosystem.
Completion session. Usually, what happens like when you are attending an online? Usually, what happens like you need to put some like a phone call or having that. But here, the completion session is happening casually. Like, I don't need to even like plan something. One is, of course, the planned programs are happening. Like we are having a regular Bhagavad Gita chanting, and we are having happening about a lot of different sessions that acharyas are taking here. Even Gulukul Balasans is helping us to take online sessions from different campuses. So, but apart from that, in the morning when we are discussing casually, so that enlightenment ecosystem is such, even though your small incompletions, you are being inserted into a powerful cognition with small, even while we're having a food, for example, and the conversations that we have. So such a beautiful ambience. Like, usually I'll be like working, and I love to go and spend time outside, basically. So that kind of environment is created here. So I think I personally feel nobody should miss this opportunity, especially at this initial stage. We should not miss this opportunity to be part of this ecosystem and enjoy this fresh air, enjoy this enlightened ecosystem that Swamiji has blessed us. Of course, Adi Kailash, no words, right? So it's Adi Kailash where Swamiji was there. So no, you cannot describe it. Whatever you describe, it's less. So at least you should experience that once. And especially if you're an IT person where you're working from home, I don't see any reason to be there. Anybody who has an option for working from home, there is no reason for you to stay back after so much of warnings that Swamiji has given us on the third day.
Everyone, now you have to make yourself your projects or something to work from home. That should be your priority if that is, you know, if you have any other pressure. So when I'm just talking to many people, that's what I emphasize. Even if you're taking a little more months to get that aligned, I humbly request all of you to bring your spouse or someone caretaker and your kids to, you know, preserve it first. Absolutely, there should not be any problem for any of the kids. Schools are going to be online, so there should not be any problem. Immediately let them come first and get settled, then you also align yourself and come. I'm just sharing this experience since we are talking to many people. What are the, you know, practical problems? They say these and that. Whatever your problems are there, yeah, try to align you. Take a step. Swamiji will help you in just getting align your work. And your kids and your spouse, let them be here as quick as possible. That's the very important life step you have to take.
Which I'd like to share about the food. The each and every meal, we are getting around 11 items per each meal, actually. So I was asking, like, I was casually talking to my wife, and usually if you are a housewife or you are cooking every day, right? So that cooking tension is also not there. And you are being served 11 different items every meal, lunch, breakfast, and dinner, with a balanced nutrition, right? So like how the typical or traditional food with as per the Bhaga Sastra. So how the meals are served, exactly it is served in the same way. And the care in which you'll be getting is like every day you will receive a call and whether everything is okay. Or the medical team is every time they are always bothered about your well-being, and that is something that everybody should experience. And at this stage is I think that is something that we should not stop anything from coming to Adi Kailash, and we should reach here as soon as that, that's what my personal feeling is. We should reach here as soon as possible and enjoy this beautiful ambience.
That's all.
So beautifully shared, Agniya and Abhimukhaya. It really, I'm sure for those of us who are watching us on YouTube and watching us live on Facebook, they're all, you literally took us and made us experience what it is to live in Adi Kailash. And we have the YouTube actually flooding with the comments of our viewers who are sharing their comments and their views on your sharing. So beautifully shared. And I'm going to share some of what the YouTube viewers have been sharing, listening to your sharing. So let's see some of the YouTube comments. Okay, so here we have a YouTube viewer, Susan Davidson. has posted saying, I have shared it with 15 people and on Facebook. So she shared it on Facebook with 15 people, the live feed, and Devi Kama has shared it on WhatsApp. And we have Devika Rani from Malaysia saying, yes, we feel so blessed. We used to enjoy Adi Kailash ambience and ecosystem during Inner Awakening. And I miss that ambience. I'm sure all of us totally agree with you, Devika Ma. You know, whoever has been in that ambience, really we miss enjoying the ambience of intense presence of Swamiji in Adi Kailasha. And Ma Durgananda is saying we have to wait for another few years before we come to India. Absolutely. You know, once Swamiji's divine feet touches and takes care of the hell that's, you know, India's attracting because of the collective negativity, then it'll be safe for us to go. And Ma Durgananda is saying the kids would really enjoy Adi Kailash Vatavarana. They'll be living and in an enlightened energy field. Parents, you just need to jump in, drop the mind of resistance or laziness. So if you are watching and if you are in India and if you are not yet in Adi Kailash, the first thing that you need to do is pack your bags and move to Adi Kailash and experience that beautiful ambience. We have Iris Lazovsky saying, so beautiful, an enlightened baby coming. That is for Agni Aya. And Madhukananda saying, this baby will be an enlightened baby after living in Swamiji's energy field for so many months. And Edison is saying, I love you so much, Swamiji. And what a nice temple-based lifestyle again. And Ma Jyoti Kunda is saying, wow, Swamiji's kindness, love and compassion is beyond words. I'm already missing Vidadi. And she's saying to Abhimuktaya and Agni, saying, you guys are so fortunate and so blessed. Devikama is saying, I can relate with everything they are saying. Beautiful life and lovely surroundings. A spiritual lifestyle. Indeed, blessed devotees. And so beautiful. It is like having a vacation with Swamiji instead of living in fear in the society. That's absolutely what Swamiji has listed. We totally agreed. And thank you so much, Agni Aya and Abhimukta Aya. Thank you so much for coming and sharing your experience with us live. Is there anything else you would like to share before we conclude?
Yeah, and thank you so much, Ma, for giving us this opportunity to share in TV. It was really nice seeing all the comments. And really, I'm also thankful for watching, for all of us to watching this and have a beautiful comments in it. And more than that, I would really like to thank Swamiji for providing this beautiful ambience and no words to express the gratitude. But that is something that we are truly blessed to be part of this great spiritual experience, that too in Adi Kailash. So that is, yeah. Thank you, Ma.
Thank you so much.